हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल मेक महाराष्ट्र। हियर विल गेट मैक्सिमम एजुकेशनल वीडियोस। नाउ आई एम हियर। एज आई टोल्ड यू इन प्रीवियस सेशन, विल सी अबाउट द साइंटिस्ट विच हैड डिराइव्ड द थियरीज रिलेटेड टू द स्लाइडिंग कॉन्टैक्ट बेयरिंग। नाउ दिस इज द फर्स्ट वन, पेट्रोफ, एंड दिस he has developed the equation. That equation we can say that it is called as a Petrov's equation. So now Petrov, he has explained what happened, why this need of the scientist. Basically what happened, in case of the sliding contact bearing, we cannot able to find the torque developed in the system, because what happened, you can see here the shaft is rotated inside the lubricant, inside the bush. In that case the shaft is required some torque to get the balance lubricant. For that it required the torque. So there are the basically two type of the torque. First torque is from the viscous drag. Because of it motion, what will be the changes are occur, that is viscous drag. And second one is a frictional torque. So these two this Petrov has considered. So I'll explain one by one. So just listen. This is journal shaft. This is length of the bearing L. This is NS, RPM of the shaft on which bearings are mounted, correct? Then W is the load toward the center at the bearing, because bearings are circular, and small r, capital R, HO by C, oil film thickness and all that we have seen in previous session. So I'll explain one by one. I'll read for you. R is the small radius, that is radius of the shaft. Capital R is the bigger radius, that is bearing radius. L is the length of the bearing. C is the radial clearance, and it can be defined by R minus R. NS is the speed of the journal. V is the pitch line velocity. Generally we can say that at the surface, the circular surface is there, that due to that 2 pi R NS, this will be the pitch line velocity. Absolute viscosity is Newton per second. Generally we can consider Newton second per mm square. W is the radial load. PB is important, radial, that is bearing pressure. So pressure can be sustained by the bearing with respect to rotation of the shaft, that is bearing pressure. And generally it can be calculated load by area. Load is W, area is 2R. Why 2R? The bearing shaft area, shaft radius is smaller, 2R into with respect to length of the bearing, that is area. So that is the bearing pressure. Now these are the terminology. I hope you understood this. Please check it. Clear? Next. Now I'll develop the torque, which I told you the two type of the torque for deriving this Petrov equation. First, just listen. The tangential frictional force acting on a journal, that is shaft, due to viscous drag. Because of the motion of the shaft, the viscous drag is coming over the structure. Therefore, we can calculate by using Newton's law of viscosity, which we had already defined. F is equal to, force is equal to, that is we have calculated. I think you might have remembered this. Tau is equal to mu into dv by dh, velocity with respect to height. So tau is equal to F by A. Therefore, F is equal to mu into A. That equation directly coming here. Mu into A dv by dh. Now area, so area of the bearing is having circular arrangement, so circle, that is 2 pi r with respect to length, that is mu into 2 pi r l into velocity with respect to clearance. Frictional force is equal to mu into 2 pi r l. V is nothing but, as we have written here, V is nothing but velocity 2 pi r ns, velocity of the surface with respect to shaft rotation. So I have mentioned here the value of V and divided by C, correct? Now, so the frictional torque due to the viscous drag is, torque is nothing but force into radius. So force we have calculated this, and radius is small r of the shaft. So therefore, if I convert this equation, simplify format, it will gives you torque is equal to, that is viscous drag. The torque is equal to 4 pi square into r cube mu, that is absolute viscosity, into length of the bearing into shaft rpm divided by clearance. So this will be your first equation, very first equation for the considering torque. Next, The frictional torque can be considered due to friction. Now, due to friction, torque is equal to coefficient of friction FWR, that is F into load applied at the center with respect to radius. See, T is equal to FWR. F is the coefficient of friction in between shaft and bush. W is the load acting at a center and R is the small radius. That's why this will be the torque by using frictional force. So T is equal to FWR. So F is coefficient of friction, T is torque. Now this torque, we know that F as it is, W is nothing but, see here, we have written here, PB, bearing pressure, is equal to W by 2R, that is load by area. So therefore W is equal to PB into 2R L, length of the bearing. So I have written here W is equal to PB 2R L into R. So therefore the torque coming due to friction is 2F PB, that is bearing pressure, into L into R square. So I will equate this second equation. This is second equation. So I'll equate equation number 1 and 2. We'll get, see, this I have equated. So I'll get the friction occurs in the system, F is equal to 2 pi square R by C mu ns by PB. This is the simplified format of the coefficient of the friction. So this equation is called as a Petrov equation, and in that he has indicated the two dimensional parameters such as R by C, that is radius by clearance, and mu ns by PB, that influence the coefficient of friction and other frictional properties of the bearing. So likewise, the frictional property we have calculated by using Petrov equation. So this was the derivation which will be asked for the exam. Correct? I hope you understood the things. So I'll repeat this, revise this, what we have covered today. So we have covered the structure, we have covered the notations required for it. We have using two torques, that is torque acting frictional torque due to viscous drag. So we have developed this, and torque due to friction, and just equating 1 and 2, I'll get the Petrov equation to find out the coefficient of friction. Clear? We are regularly uploading the videos, so please take a benefit of it. Right now the situation is very dangerous, so that we are learning online. So take a benefit of this and